Calvin Boons and Spookios. Spooky right disclaimer. Happy Halloween, everybody. It's me, Calvin Benson. And welcome back to Spooptober. And I'm really in the Halloween mood. And I want other people to be in the mood too. And what better way to do that is to tell some scary stories. So in this video, I will tell you 4 spoopy stories. So without further ado, let us begin. Killer in the Backseat. Once there was a woman. Her name was Mrs. Myers. She was working late at her night job. She got finished late at night. She got into her car and was driving home. But as she got onto the freeway, she noticed that there was a car following her. So she switched lanes, but so did the car. The woman turned off the freeway, but the car was still trailing her. But now, the car kept flickering its headlights, so she sped up, and she was so terrified. She turned onto a street, and the car followed, still lights still flickering on and off. She began to panic, and she pulled into her driveway. Then the car following her stopped on the side of the street. She opened her car door and ran towards her house. "Ma'am, what?" the man yelled, cut off by her slamming the door shut. She immediately called the police on her cell phone, but was informed they were already headed to her house. When the police arrived, they informed her that the man in the car was following her, not to harm her, but to warn her. Warned her that there was a man in the back seat holding a knife. She was terrified and didn't understand how she didn't notice a man in her back seat. The police entered her car and found the knife stabbed through the driver's seat. The end. That card could be a little more spoopy. There we go, and maybe add a little ghost emoji. Ooh, that's so spoopy. Okay, now on to the next story. School night. There was a woman. She was a teacher at the school in her hometown. But this is no ordinary school. The school is very old and is said to be haunted by many of the dead staff who worked there. One day she had to stay a bit late afterwards to grade papers. She and one of her teacher friends were the only people in the building. Not even the janitorial staff was there. So as she was grading papers, she heard a noise. It was a tapping noise coming from the back of her classroom. Her classroom is a rectangular room, which is very large, and one section at the back of the room was walled off like a closet. She decided to just ignore the sound, and eventually she had to go out to her car and get something she had left in it. After she got it, she was walking back inside. But as she looked at the school, she saw a grinning, dark figure standing in one of the windows, more specifically, her classroom window. The figure looked nothing like her friend, and she knew for a fact that she and her friend were the only people left in the school. She immediately ran into the school to alert her friend of the figure. But after searching around the entire school for anyone else, they found no one. And that was her first encounter with a ghost in the school. The end. Wait, why is it cursive now? Okay, that's a stock photo. No, it's just freaking SpongeBob. Look here, this is good enough. Ooh, so spoopy. Next story. The Cult in the Corn. There was a kid named Brad. He was spending the weekend with his grandparents at their farm. And right in front of their farmhouse was a large field of grass. And at night, a few cows roamed around in it. One night, they were all asleep. Then all of a sudden, Brad woke up. He had a horrible pain in his arm. But then he heard a noise coming from the cornfield outside of his window. Brad went over to the window to see what the noises were. When he looked into the corn, he saw a fire at the center of the field. When he looked closer, he saw a group of cloaked people in a circle doing a ritual. Brad woke up his grandparents and told them, and they locked all the windows and doors. They just watched them from a distance until they left. And in the morning, we all went out to where they were. Brad and his family went out to where they were in the field to see if there was anything out there. They saw a charcoal fireplace, a bloody piece of clothing, and a voodoo doll with a needle through its arm. The voodoo doll resembled Brad. The end. Oh, come on, editor guy, you know that's the wrong emoji. No, no. Censor that one. No. Finally! Oh, come on! Just go to the last story. April Fools. Michael was a normal man. He lived alone in a small house in a small neighborhood and had just one friend who lived right next to him. And it was April Fool's Day. He was just relaxing on his sofa chair, drawing some illustrations on his iPad. Then he heard the sound of footsteps coming from behind his chair. Then he heard a voice. I'm coming for you. Mike was too terrified to move. After a minute of standing still, he mustered up his courage and got out of his chair and turned around. Then Mike saw that the kitchen door to the kitchen was creaked open a bit. He walked over and fully opened it, and there was a tall figure in a pink bunny mask holding a knife. The figure walked closer and closer to Mike, who was too scared to move. The figure was right in front of Mike. The figure pulled off the bunny mask, revealing itself to just be Mike's friend. April Fools, he said, as he bent the knife, showing that it was just rubber. Mike let out a big breath of relief. Man, you really got me. I love the part that you whispered in my ear, but how did you do that in the bunny mask? Said Mike. I didn't whisper in your ear, said Mike's friend. They were both terrified, but they knew what to do. They ran out of the house and called the police. When the police got there, they searched the entire house. They found the man in the closet. They dragged him out onto the lawn, and Mike could see the man's face clearly. He had long black hair, yellow eyes, and a wide grin. The police shoved him into the car, and they started to drive off. But Mike felt like something was off. And as he turned around and looked back at his house, he saw someone in his window. The end, for real this time. So that's 4 spoopy stories. Did you get scared? Great, but in case you aren't scared, you and everyone you know and love will die one day and will be nothing. In just 200 years, you will be completely forgotten as if you never existed. When you die, you will never come back. People say there was an afterlife or just something once you die, but there was nothing after this. Sleep for all eternity. You cannot think, feel, move, love, or taste. You will become nothing for all eternity. Ha ha, that was sure was fun. Remember to wear face masks, wash your hands, and even though 2020 is one of the worst years of the 21st century, at least we can still go trick-or-treating. Son of a...
And shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul, seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons speak with such a screech. You'll shake and shudder in surprise when you hear these zombies shriek.
We're so sorry, skeletons, you're so misunderstood. You only want to socialize,
but I don't think we should.
For
spooky, scary skeleton shouts startling, shrilly screams. The sneak from their sarcophagus and just won't leave you be. Skeletons will wake you with a